Hi, Jim. It's Kylie Renna with Ring and SEO. Thanks for taking the time to talk to me earlier on the phone. I hope that this video helps business out. I'm not sure what exactly you're trying to gain, if you're trying to get more business, but I hope that this at least helps give some informational intake for you so that you can improve in a couple different aspects here. So normally I do this a little bit different, but there's a couple things that are missing that aren't going to allow me to do so. Number one, I couldn't find a website for you. It doesn't look like you have one. Maybe you just have a Facebook page. So there's no website that I can base off of. So the three things that I would normally talk to somebody about is kind of going to be a little bit difficult, but content, citations, and backlinks are the three things I like to go over for any business. They're the top three things that Google looks for in the ranking process. So to get your name at the top of Google and make business skyrocket. As far as that goes, being that we have no website, it can't really go over content, but if you're interested in a website, I can go over those things with you and explain how content works and how important keywords and key phrases and the amount of content on your page and what content actually consists of. I can go over that with you if you're interested. I was going to do this part a little bit different too. So citations is something I want to talk to you about. Citations are online directories. So anywhere that your business name, address, and phone number are listed on the web. LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, Yellow Pages. Those are all going to be, and it looks like you've got, some of these might be you here. So you might be on Yelp and some of these, but you don't have an actual Google My Business page as far as I can tell. Normally you would see that here. If I type in Jim's Plumbing, Dearborn, Michigan, usually your GMB, your little snack pack, would pull up right here and it'd have your reviews and your information, company address if you have one, all that fun stuff, but I'm not seeing one. So creating a GMB is probably your first step next to a website if you're interested. GMB is super important. I wasn't going to talk to you about this, but what I did want to point out is that if you type in Jim's Plumbing, Dearborn, Michigan, a lot of these here, since they're directories, people will associate them with ads and they'll actually scroll right past them. And then what's gonna happen is they're gonna look at your top three competitors here. And so when I type in Jim's Plumbing, Dearborn, Michigan, they're actually seeing all these other companies, which is not good for business. So it's basically driving business away from you. So they're typing in your name, but they're getting brought to these top three companies right here. If I was a consumer and I was looking for something, I want the easiest, quickest plumber I could find. Usually it's an emergency, I need it done now. I'm gonna click on Best Plumbing here or Five Guys Plumbing, and it's gonna take that business right away from you. So creating that GMB, having citations, so citations, like I said, anywhere your business name, address, and phone number are listed, looking at your competition and seeing how many citations they have, where they're getting those citations from, and you can actually get a list of those. Piggybacking off of those, make sure you have everything they have and more. So having more than them is super, super important. I did want to point that out just because I don't want you losing business because of the way that this is pulling up. So like I said, I wasn't going to talk about this, but it's right here in front of my face and I couldn't help but at least explain that to you to make sure that business isn't being lost because of that and being driven to other companies. So they're basically taking business from you. This is a tool here that I have called Ahrefs. This is a tool that we use that looks at the overview of a website. It tells us how strong the website is, where their backlinks are coming from, the domains that they're referring them from, and organic keywords that they're using to rank their website. It also will tell us their traffic value, etc. This tool is not 100% accurate, however, it is fairly close. 99% of marketing companies out there do not understand SEO. They are not trained in SEO, which is search engine optimization. You know, you got GoDaddy and all these other sites that, you know, they'll make you a pretty website, but they don't understand how to rank it on Google. So you spend all your money and time building just a pretty face with some makeup, but it doesn't do you any good. So paying attention to that is super important. Make sure that a company, if you're ever going to use a company for any type of SEO, whether it's me or somebody else, that you know what you're paying for and that it's going to actually bring you value. This is one of the competitors out there. They've got, and I don't want these numbers to scare you because this is a number one position site. Being in those top three is the most important. So the next one down might be quite a bit less than this. So squeezing in there wouldn't be that hard to do. It just would take a little bit of effort. You've got over 5,000 backlinks coming from 165 domains. Now, these domains are providing a link back to this website either by photo or a direct link to the website. Now, all backlinks are not created equal. So these backlinks are providing power or juice to your website, and it's basically making Google say, oh, hey, this is a trusted website. They should be number one, okay? So making sure that your backlinks are coming from a powerful source and that the domain has something to do with plumbing. So it's not, you know, a domain that's coming from an ice cream shop or a tire company. Obviously, you want something similar to what you're trying to relay to customers. And that's going to tell Google that you're a trusted source. It's going to give you power. It's going to make you rank higher in Google. Now, this is the number one competitor. So I would say if you're going to go for doing a website in a GMB, you're going to want to look at their organic keywords that they're using. So they've got 116 organic keywords here that they're using to rank on Google, and it's putting them number one. Now, the position here is what I want to look at. I'm going to try to do this from, so actually you could probably, so they're number two. So this is page one. It's all page one. Once we get to 11 here, this is getting to page two. So if they look up plumbers in Dearborn, they're actually on page two, and this is your number one competitor. So actually going on here and doing some of these things that I can teach you is going to slap you in a number one position probably fairly easily, as long as you can get these backlinks and that power to your website. So going over those, looking at your top competitors and saying, hey, look, this is what, finding a goal, this is what I want to do with my company, this is where I want to be, this is how much I want to make in addition to what I'm already doing, and figuring out where you need to squeeze in the, to make that happen. And piggybacking, like I said, off of these companies, creating a website, creating a GMB, because neither of those things exist, and that's not helping you at all. And like I said here, I want to stress this one more time. If I type in Jim's Plumbing, Dearborn, Michigan, I'm going to skip through these because I go Yelp, Yellow Page. I don't even want to look at those. That's too much hassle. And I'm going to go, okay, never mind about Jim's. I'm going to click on Best Plumbing or Five Guys or A1 Bargain. Because they're right there in front of my face. They've got good reviews, you know, 49 five-star reviews. They seem good. All right, I need a plumber today. That's who I'm going to call. Okay. So that's hurting you. That's hurting business. So fixing that is super important. I hope that you got some information from this video, and I hope that it helps business. If you have any questions, please feel free to reach out, and please, please, please provide some feedback after you've watched this video. I would greatly appreciate it. Thank you so much.